Okay, let's go to rank.
Is this you?
You just got home. You walked away from GameStop. You bought DOA 6. You're getting ready to go online, rank up.
But it takes you 10 minutes to find a match.
There we go. There we go. We're doing it. We're doing it. No. Dude, stop. 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 I couldn't believe it. Why would Dead or Alive destroy my controller like that? Why is it every time I pick Mila, my opponent looks at me like I'm a top tier character? You saw where I started. You saw where I came from. How many controllers do you think I went through until I got this C rank and kept it for 2 years?
I hope you like your hands extra salty.
Alright, bruh. Look at this dude.
I can't take him serious. Ow! Alright, my first match is going to be against Rig. One thing you're going to notice is I'm going to tackle the shit out of him.
Watch out.
I'm trying to do this really cool strategy where I do that little jab. Yeah, that one. And unfortunately, he's the good man. This Rig, he's out to get my C rank for sure. And I won't let him get it. I'm the best C rank. He keeps up the pressure, but I'm just going to keep slapping him. Ow! I don't know why I think that scream is so funny. Let's go. Oh, wait. Hold up, Rig. I think you got something on your foot. Round two. And you know he's angry if he's throwing out random kicks like that. Stay on the floor, bitch. Stay back, bitch. Aw, shit. He can just throw me in the air like that and catch me with his foot? I've been practicing and I actually got a little bit better at blocking. So I'm actually, you know, trying to actually do a throw punish. And one thing you'll notice is that I keep trying to either do a feint or try a way to fake him out. Mostly by spamming, but, you know, a fake out is a fake out. The best part about Mila, other than people think that you're a top tier player immediately, is the fact that she's got so many different approaches. The tension.
No! God, please, no!
Dude, if I were him, I would hate getting continuously tackled. Alright, you know what? I feel bad for him. I'm gonna let him have this. I'm gonna let him hit me for a little bit. What the fuck? Alright, come here, little guy. Come here, little buddy. Get over here, Papa Rig. Get over here, big Rigatoni! Let's go!
Oh my god. Oh my god, he on X Games mode.
Oh, the serotonin going into my veins right now. Oh wow, he's already starting just kicking and screaming. Let me hold you. Let me hold you. Alright, dude. Alright, we gotta talk about this move real quick. Start taking notes.
Write that down, write that down!
This is one of Mila's most underrated attacks ever. It's called 1P plus K, but I'm not gonna call it that. I'm gonna call it the hidden jab. Because 1P plus K sounds like something a nerd would say. Hear me out. I don't simp for a lot of things in life, except this particular attack. Every time I play Mila, inject this attack into my veins. It's a 17 frame move. It's not the fastest move, but it's definitely not slow. Upon hitting your opponent, it can give you a 17 frame advantage so you can safely follow up with a standard kick or a punch. If you hit a guarding opponent, you are only at a 9 frame disadvantage, which means that you have enough time to guard for most retaliating attacks, except those cheap ass characters. It is considered a crouching medium punch attack, so it ducks high attacks, and since it's also a mid punch, makes it harder for your opponent to hold since mid attack holds are split between punches and kicks. Lastly, look at this Rig. Look at him. It is striking fear into his face. I mean, just spam this move. All right, so here I do my hidden jab again. Oh my god, I've had enough of your book. Practically free damage. It's free. It's a free win. Who am I playing against? Bougie bitch? Yeah, dude, this is a free win. This is quality content. This is free. Gratis. 5-finger discount. Free 99. All right, Papa Rig's catching up, but that's okay because I'm ready for a wake up special.
Comes a giant fish!
He hit the wall hard. Okay. I thought I had a better follow-up. But this, he was not expecting this.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
I love this move. I love it so much. I don't even care what happens. I'm just gonna keep doing it. Going on? No. You know, we gave him that one, but it's okay because I'm the best C rank player in the world. There's no way I can lose.
You may not like it, but this is peak Mila gameplay. Mila's fist go. Let's finish this. Time to end this. Do you know what Mila's machine gun punches remind me of? Check this out. I cannot stop thinking about this. The king goes. Shoot, I can't even talk. You know, sometimes I get messages about people asking me if it's easy being such a high ranked C ranked player and also spamming and doing the hidden jab all at the same time. And I gotta tell you, yeah, it is pretty easy doing that. Like, I love it. This is it right here. This whole match has led up to this exact moment. Stay on the ground, son. Don't even come at me.
I'm going to the top.
By far, one of the coolest things Mila can do is the feint. Yeah, I know, it's weird to say. Mila has several different ways to lean into her feint. Hey, see what I did there? Lean into a feint? Come on, just laugh at one of my jokes, please.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
These are the different approaches to a feint. Each one is useful for different situations. The standard throw cancel feint, the one punch man, the fake kick, the useless one, the uppercut backstep, the spinneroony, the 1-2, the 1-2-3, the dirty fake out, the kick psych, the bait kick, the dirty left inside. One of the benefits to executing a feint is that it's a simple variable string that has similar looking attacks that you can cancel. So in doing similar looking strings but canceling them at quote unquote random times, you can control momentum as well as keep your opponent guessing. Hey, did you see Mila and all those feints?
Mila punches go.
An additional benefit to the feint is that it's technically a stance that ducks high attacks. As a stance, you get access to certain attacks you can't do in your neutral position. I won't go over everything, maybe I can save that for another video, but you gain access to one of Mila's most powerful moves, the tackle.
Oh no, not the tackle.
Any real Mila player knows that the tackle can be done on its own. However, not everyone knows that the tackle can be chained from the feint itself or that the tackle can be canceled into a feint. I made this incredibly detailed and impressive flowchart using Microsoft Paint. I also don't want you hating on my flowchart. I didn't see any of you five people watching making a flowchart, so back off. Now, based on your approach, you have three different routes to take. First, are you doing a pure tackle throw or canceling it into a feint? From here, if you are canceling it, then proceed to your feint attacks. If you are committing to the throw, then proceed to your mount punches or your mount throw. In the next route, there are some strings that are pure feint strings. These are scripted combos that allow for a cancel and will directly lead into your feint stance. From the feint stance, you can choose from the different feint specific attacks. Gosh, that was hard to say. The third route is the backstep. Mila has three different attacks that lead into the backstep stance. From the backstep stance, you can go into the tackle throw and either commit to the throw or cancel out of it into a feint, then go into any of your feint stance attacks. So you have three different routes, and two of those routes have an option in them that let you either throw or cancel into a feint. In a tackle mount position, you have an option between three punches or follow-up throw. If you choose the feint stance, then you have about five different options of attacks to choose from, ranging from mid and low attacks and alternating between a kick and a few punches. Look, I'm not a mathematician, but basically, If you multiply the amount of options in between options, you pretty much got 1 million, gazillion, bajillion possibilities.
But do not quote me on that.
In the last step of the flowchart, depending on whether you are winning or losing, you can either start again from any of the three routes, or if you win, just pass go, collect your W, break your opponent's controller so he can teach them a lesson for challenging you in the first place, and rank up. Next fight is going to be against Lei Fang, aka hashtag Lei Gang. Where my Lei Fang mangs at? Just kidding, ain't nobody want to see you. Go back inside your house. It's quarantine. Stay at least 6 feet away from me. I don't want your controller touching me. Anyway, I used to play Lei Fang, so I'm in her head already. God, oh my god, oh my god. This is why Mila is so good. Because we just did that bait kick. We baited the Lei Fang. I wanted to see if she blocked. And then we did a kick, transitions into the tackle throw, and now we're in the mounted position where we can wreck shop. Man, that's so good.
I'm too tired. I'm just gonna lay down right here.
Bait him with the fatal rush and then go into the cheap low kick and proceed into the tackle. Because, such a cool move.
That's a lot of damage.
I am so disappointed in you and Lei Fang. How dare you strike me low? How dare you hit me where I'm not looking? So I don't know how anybody else feels here, any other Mila players, but I give this match favor to Lei Fang because her kit allows her to counter most of Mila's opening outside of low kicks, and that makes you predictable. I want to stop and analyze what just happened right there. So we did our bait kick just how we did our tackle earlier in the match, except this time, instead of doing the tackle, we canceled it and went into our feint stance and did the machine gun punches. That's the awesome part about being Mila. These are the cool benefits of joining the Mila Club, is that you get all these ways to trick and bamboozle your opponent.
Oh my god. Oh my god, he on X Games mode.
Hey bro, watch your jet. Watch your jet, bro. Watch your jet!
Oh wow, this is still going. You can stop, Mila. Please stop. Please stop.
There comes a giant fish!
You know what? This is a really fun game. I like this game a lot.
I'm going to the top.
So for the last match, we're going up against a friend, actually. Richmatic. He's got a Twitch channel, twitch.tv. Yo, it's Richmatic if you want to check him out. I don't go up against Nico very often, so I'm not sure what... Oh. She can just dematerialize and reatomize on top of my head. She can teleport. She can throw lightning too. Oh wow, so you know me, a Mila player using a mixed martial arts fighting style, going up against someone throwing actual lightning at me. Oh, this is completely fair. So lucky enough for Ridge, they call me the Lightning Patrol. So get on the ground and let me mount you so I can keep you grounded. You're gonna pay for that.
There comes a giant fish!
That's a lot of damage.
Look at this health difference. This is it. We got this in the bag. No! Absolute bullcrap. I should have had that. I was in the lead. Look at him just stand there. Menacingly.
Go crazy! Go stupid! Ah!
Blocking against Rich right now is very hard because he's not afraid to grab. Yeah, he will throw punish me if I give him the opportunity and whiff.
Look at this dude.
Oh no, I'm not done with you. Give me that leg. That's prime leg real estate, bro. Unlike my other DOA brethren, I'm not afraid to hold, and I'll be as cheap as I wanna be. So my new strategy going forward is to misdirect my opponent as well as to just drop combos. You should honestly just be fearing me right now. Look at how I held this high hold, and look at that mid kick hold. Let me drop some knowledge on you. If you see your opponent laying down on the floor, just walk around them. You will increase the likelihood that they do a wake up kick because one, wake up kicks track because you're walking around them. And two, it's disrespectful to walk around a person laying on the floor. This is a galaxy brain strategy. What a brain buster. As a top C rank player, this fight makes me incredibly nervous because he's blocking almost everything I'm doing and as well as stopping my throws. I don't know what I could have done better, to be frank. I got my Wi-Fi router. It's on top of my PS4. So between these holds and moving my Wi-Fi router closer, I'm hoping I can close the gap and get this victory. You see how right here her head is barely in frame? That's how you need to talk to these Nico players. You need to talk down to them. Alright, I'm gonna try doing my hidden jab. Nope. Okay. These holds. These holds, though. These holds.
Bro, let me just hold you one more time, please. Please. Just please.
How dare he? How dare he hold me like that? That is terrible. But it's okay, because we're gonna play this safe. We're gonna block where we can. Oh, that was not safe. But dude, give me that arm. Oh, look at this damage. Look at this damage. We're done. Hey, how you doing? It's me, Romero. I hope you're enjoying the video. Look what's going on here. We are both one mistake away from dying. He just did his ultimate, which means that if this hits me, it's gonna break the breakables in the back. He's gonna be able to combo me because I'm gonna be on the floor and slam me into the wall. Or I can block it and throw punish him. Or I can risk it and go for the hold.
It's a bold strategy, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off for him.
Shit, my finger slipped. I hate to do this to you, Rich, but I need to watch that replay again. Like, please, right now.
Hey, it's Mila.
It's the champ.
Yeah.
This is to just disappear all of a sudden. How could you?
Hey, thanks a lot for watching and coming to the channel. I hope you enjoyed that video. If you want, feel free to check out the description of the video. You can find me in all my socials right there, as well as the podcast that I help contribute. That also includes Joe, it's Rich Matic, who was also in the video. Other than that, you guys have a good day.